This channel's all about helping you pass your math class so you can achieve your goals and get a better life. In this problem, we're going to graph this piecewise function. Coming right up. So in order to graph this, I've got to do it in three different pieces. I've got to look at x is less than or equal to negative 2 first. So here I have x is less than or equal to negative 2. F of x equals y, doesn't it? So y, for every x that's less than or equal to negative 2, y is going to equal x squared plus 1, and I know that's going to look like a parabola. And I'm going to have to look at the endpoint. So when x equals negative 2, y equals negative 2 squared, so that's 4, plus 1, that's 5. And I've just found a point I could actually plot on a graph, so that's negative 2, 5. Let's get a couple of more points. If x is negative 3, that's negative 3 squared, so negative times a negative, that's 9, plus 1 is 10. So this point, of course, is negative 3, 10. That's probably all I'll need, but just for continuity, I'll do one more. 4 squared, that's 16, plus 1 is 17, so this point right here is negative 4, 17. And this is going to be the part of the graph just up to negative 2. And it is going to include negative 2 because it's x is less than or equal to negative 2. Next, I'll have to consider where x is between negative 2 and 3. So negative 2 for x up to and including the point positive 3. And when that's true, then y, remember y equals f of x, y is always the same, it's negative 2. So I've got to look at the endpoints. When x is negative 2, this is going to be negative 2. So the point here is negative 2, negative 2. But because it's strictly less than, I won't be able to include that point. Let's do 0, because that's kind of in the middle of negative 2 and 3. When x is 0, y is negative 2. This one's always constant, so 0, y is negative 2. And then for the endpoint, which I will have to include when x is 3, y is negative 2. So I have 3, negative 2. I'm going to have to draw each piece of this graph separately. And now, the final piece. I want to consider all the values where x is greater than, strictly greater than 3. And in this case, the y part, or the f of x part, is going to be 1/3 times x. So when x equals 3, y equals 1/3 times 3, so that's 1. So this point is 3, 1, and I wouldn't be able to include it. It's strictly greater than. Let's look at, 4 is not good, is it? Let's use a 6, because that's perfectly divisible by 3, so that's 2. So I have 6, 2, and let's use a 9. Let's just get things that are divisible by 3. 9 divided by 3 is 3, and this point, of course, is 9, 3. Now I need to plot each part of my graph separately. The final step is to graph each part of the graph, one of the 1/3 parts of the graph. So let's graph this part here, where y equals x squared plus 1 for all the x's less than or equal to 2. So when x is when x is negative 2, y equals 5. So that has to be filled in because that point is less than or equal to 2. And it's going to go up to the point negative 3, 10. And it's going to look like a parabola. So that first 1/3 is going to look like that. Next, I have to do the middle part. So between x equals minus 2, that's down here, when x equals negative 2, so does y, y equals negative 2, but I can't include that point. When x equals positive 3, y equals negative 2, but I am going to have to include that point, because when I look in the middle there, it's having a little bit of trouble with my graphics here. This has to be filled in, and that then is all the points in between. So I plot all my points, and this is a straight line. For lastly, when x equals 3, y equals 1. So there's x equals 3, y equals 1, but I cannot include that point. When x equals 6, y equals 2. When x equals 9, y equals 3. So I'm going to have this line, straight line, going up like this. So here's my graph of my piecewise function, and I had to find the points for the three different sections, and I had to graph it in the three different sections. I would like to invite you to like this video and subscribe to this channel. Thanks very much for listening.